Bless the Lord, who forgives all of our sins.
His mercy endures forever.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Almighty Father, whose dear Son, on the night before he suffered, instituted the sacrament of his body and blood, mercifully grant that we may receive it thankfully in remembrance of Jesus Christ our Lord, who in these holy mysteries gives us a pledge of eternal life, and who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Friends in Christ, in this Lenten season, we have heard our Lord's call to struggle against sin, death, and the devil, all that keeps us from loving God and each other. This is the struggle to which we were called at baptism. Within the community of the church, God never wearies of forgiving sin and giving the peace of reconciliation. On this night, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor and enter the celebration of the great 3 days, reconciled with God and with one another. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed,
by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. In obedience to the command of our Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all of your sins.
Amen. Amen.
Israel remembered its deliverance from slavery in Egypt by celebrating the festival of Passover. This festival featured the Passover lamb, whose blood was used as a sign to protect God's people from the threat of death. The early church described the Lord's Supper using imagery from the Passover, especially in portraying Jesus as the lamb who delivers God's people from sin and death. The first reading is from Exodus, in chapter 12, starting with the first verse. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, you are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who eat it. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a year-old male. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. Then the whole assembled congregation of Israel shall slaughter it at twilight. They shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorsteps and the lintel of the houses in which they eat it. They shall eat the lamb that same night. They shall eat it roasted over the fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. Do not eat any of it raw or boiled in water, but roast it over the fire with its head, legs, and inner organs. You shall let none of it remain until the morning. Anything that remains until the morning you shall burn. This is how you shall eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, and you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you in the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout your generations, you shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance." The second reading is from 1 Corinthians. In the bread and cup of the Lord's Supper, we experience intimate fellowship with Christ and with one another, because it involves his body given for us and the new covenant in his blood. Faithful participation in this meal is a living proclamation of Christ's death until he comes in the future. I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes."
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, Lord Christ. Now, before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand. Peter said to him, You will never wash my feet. Jesus answered, Unless I wash you, you have no share with me. Simon Peter said to him, Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head. Jesus said to him, One who is bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you. For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason he said, Not all of you are clean. After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example that you also should do as I have done to you. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Our evening gathering brings the observation of Lent to a close as we join with Christians around the world to observe the Triduum, the 3 days marking Jesus' death and resurrection. It is a beloved part of Holy Week, though, that many skip, choosing instead to dwell in the procession, branches, and celebration of Palm Sunday, or looking forward to Easter morning with its flowers and soaring organ and brass, the most beautiful service of the year. But I love Maundy Thursday, because somehow if I don't experience the shadows and everything stripped bare, the new dawn of resurrection just doesn't mean as much. It's kind of like lighting a candle when the power goes out at home to help find your way around the house. But light a candle in a bright room, even though it might be beautiful, it's not critical or really appreciated. And so once a year, worship brings us to gather in the evening, to a meal in an upper room where friend turns traitor, and then to a garden of hard-fought prayer, and then a rest. On to a kangaroo court and to an execution. Once a year, we have this opportunity to peer into a shadowy abyss and to remember all whose suffering was mirrored on that cross. The oppressed, the dying, the unjustly accused, the deserted, the hopeless. Once a year, we leave the place of worship in shadows and silence to ponder what has begun to unfold. Yes, we'll return after the 3 days with tears replaced with laughter and the darkness of tonight and tomorrow replaced with glorious light and joy. But, beloveds, the shadows and the silence, they give light its purpose. And they frame Jesus' command for us to live out the promise embodied in the Eucharist. We call today Maundy, after all. Kind of a weird word, but it's a word from the Latin that means command. In John's Gospel, when Jesus commands us to love one another, he reminds us that we do that in the same way that he loved us. The Eucharist is commanded by Jesus for the continual remembrance of his life and his death and his resurrection. It is a sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving in the way the sacrifice of Jesus the Christ is made present and unites us to this offering of himself. It's only a simple meal, a little bit of bread, a small sip of wine. And we call it Eucharist, which means thanksgiving. We also know it as Holy Communion, the Lord's Supper, the Divine Liturgy, the Mass, the Great Offering. Through it, we receive forgiveness of our sins and we receive strengthening of our union with Christ and with one another. And in it, we have a foretaste of all that is to come, a taste of that heavenly banquet and life everlasting. Tonight, we hear about the Passover lamb, Jesus' last meal with his disciples before his death. We hear from Paul the directions for the church in keeping the Eucharist. In the gospel, we hear about Jesus washing his disciples' feet, part of John's signs and obedience discourse about the meaning of Jesus' ministry and all that is contained in the meal itself. And after we celebrate the Eucharist, worship concludes with a dimming of the lights, and we will strip the chancel bare of all adornment in preparation for tomorrow, for Good Friday. It is in remembering the Passover, the Last Supper, and the foot washing that in the face of all of the brokenness and the suffering and the death of our world, we recognize that God's word comes to us now, in this time, even when we cannot gather in person for the Holy Meal. The word which takes these 3 nights to say, which covers all 3 of the great 3-day worship services, that word comes to us in Jesus. That word is our forgiveness. That word is the Lamb whose blood marks the doors of our houses and our very bodies. In the power of the Holy Spirit, he has washed our feet and our lives, and he turns us towards our neighbors. In this word, in the word of Jesus, and in the cross that's proclaimed tomorrow, and resurrection proclaimed Saturday night, Easter dawns. Life comes forth out of the shadows and the suffering. Please join us tomorrow at noon as worship continues, and then again Saturday at 7 p.m. as the great 3 days plays out.
Oh,
prayers of the people. As Jesus calls us to love one another, let us pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. Blessed are you, O God, for the church. Strengthen your people gathered around the globe on this holy day in homes, in churches, and outside under your sky. Bless the church's deacons and all congregational ministries. Give us hunger for your word and joy in receiving it. Feed us at all our tables with your blessing. Hear us, holy God.
We call upon your name.
Blessed are you for this good earth. Cleanse and protect the water you have given for our drinking and our washing. Sustain crops and herds that provide our food. Teach us how to live so that there is enough for all. Hear us, bountiful God.
We call upon your name.
Blessed are you for our nation. Lead us out of ancient patterns of prejudice. Protect all people throughout the world who flee violence and oppression. Establish wise and just leadership in every place and peace where there is violence and war. Hear us, sovereign God.
We call upon your name.
Blessed are you for caring for the needy. Feed the hungry. Give jobs to the unemployed. Embrace all who are isolated and lonely. Comfort those living with guilt and those who mourn. Hear us, merciful God.
We call upon your name.
Blessed are you for accompanying the sick. Bring an end to this pandemic and restore healthy and hearty connections between persons. Empower medical personnel. Receive our prayers for all we name here before you.
Bobby Mitchell, Bubba Toots, Peggy Young.
Hear us, faithful Linda God.
Oregon. We call upon your name.
Blessed are you for serving us, we who are your servants. Receive now, we pray, our silent petitions. Hear us, loving God.
We call upon your name.
Blessed are you for generations of the faithful who have proclaimed our Lord's death and lived in service to others. Unite us with them in hope until we join with them at your everlasting banquet. Hear us, eternal God.
We call upon your name.
Hear these and all our prayers, O God, in the name of the one who loves us to the end, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Redeemer.
Amen.
On this night, Jesus says, "Peace is my last gift to you. My own peace I now leave with you. Peace which the world cannot give, I give to you. I give you a new commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. Peace is my last gift to you. My own peace I now leave with you. Peace which the world cannot give, I give to you. By this shall the world know that you are my disciples, that you have love for one another."
Amen.
Let us present the offerings of our life and labor to the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, for our sins he was lifted high upon the cross, that he might draw the whole world to himself, and by his suffering and death, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who put their trust in him. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever say,
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer to you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all of your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen.
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 Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to sing.
Lead us. us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
These are the gifts of God for the people of God.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
There is a long-standing practice in the Episcopal Church to offer a means for people to receive Holy Communion spiritually when it cannot be received physically. I invite you to pray with me. My Jesus,
I believe that you are truly present in the blessed sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things and long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you in the sacrament of your body and blood, come spiritually into my heart. Cleanse and strengthen me with your grace,
Lord Jesus.
And let me never be separated from you. May I live in you and you in me, in this life and in the life to come.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory now and forever.
Amen.
O Lord, God of my salvation, when at night I cry out in your presence, let my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my cry, for my soul is full of troubles, and my life draws near to Sheol. I am counted among those who go down to the pit. I am like those who have no help, like those forsaken among the dead, like the slain that lie in the grave, like those whom you remember no more, for they are cut off from your hand. You have put me in the depths of the pit, in the regions dark and deep. Your wrath lies heavy upon me, and you overwhelm me with all your waves. Selah. You have caused my companions to shun me. You have made me a thing of horror to them. I am shut in so that I cannot escape. My eye grows dim through sorrow. Every day I call on you, O Lord. I spread out my hands to you. Do you work wonders for the dead? Do the shades rise up to praise you? Selah. Is your steadfast love declared in the grave, or your faithfulness in Abaddon? Is your steadfast love declared in the grave? Are your wonders known in the darkness, or your saving help in the land of forgetfulness? But I, O Lord, cry out to you. In the morning, my prayer comes before you. O Lord, why do you cast me off? Why do you hide your face from me? Wretched and close to death from my youth up, I suffer your terrors. I am desperate. Your wrath has swept over me. Your dread assaults destroy me. They surround me like a flood all day long. From all sides, they close in on me. You have caused friend and neighbor to shun me. My companions are in darkness.